Dear students, welcome. Thank you for tuning for another video. We are still talking about phase diagrams, which is part of the material science class. We're going to cover in this video something called the solubility limit. Before we start with the solubility limit, we need to identify and define a couple of things. When we say a solution in materials, it's a liquid or solid or gas solution that has a single phase. What we mean by a single phase is that we have the same distribution and concentration of elements in that solution everywhere. So there is no change from one location to another location of that solid, liquid, or gas. All the elements are equally distributed in the same way everywhere in that solution. If we define something called a mixture, on the other hand, so a mixture is a material that is made of multiple elements and it has more than one phase. For example, in a cube of this material, in one location within that cube, I will have different concentration than in another location. And that's what we mean by mixtures. You can see here to the right, this is one of the simplest examples of phase diagrams. I want to tell everybody that you can create phase diagrams for any mixture or any solution. It does not have to be metals. So this one happened to be a sugar-water phase diagram. So we're mixing sugar and water to come up with this diagram. If you took a look on this diagram, you can see that our y-axis is the temperature, and the x-axis is the composition. So to the left at zero point, we have all water and zero sugar. If you go to this point here, we have 80% water and 20% sugar. This is 60% water and 40% sugar. And we keep going till we reach here to the end, 100% sugar and 0% water. So you remember from last video, we said we would like to study the phase diagrams, but we need to look at the temperature, composition, and pressure. We're assuming that everything here is on the same pressure. So I hope that this is now clear. And the solubility limit is defined as the maximum concentration for which only a single phase solution exists. In this diagram here, this is our solubility limit, this curve here. This limit and curve is experimental, and anything below this curve, to the left of this curve, we have one phase, which is a solution, a liquid phase, which is the syrup. And to the right of that solubility limit, we have two phases mixed together. So the material now is a mixture of a liquid and a solid phases. And I hope that this is clear. We're going to have, this is the simplest phase diagram that we can get. We're going to move forward to much more complex phase diagrams, but in the coming videos. Now, if you want to use this phase diagram, we can have this question: what is the solubility limit for sugar in water at 20 degrees Celsius? And this is what I was saying and talking about. We would like to be able to extract some information from the phase diagrams. So this is the question: what is the solubility limit for sugar in water at 20 degrees Celsius? We come here to this figure. We would look at temperatures degrees Celsius. We draw a line to intersect with the solubility limit. And then from that intersection, we draw a line down to the x-axis to see what is the concentration of sugar. So we have this way, I just use the temperature to identify what is my concentration of at that temperature using the solubility limit. So here I know that I have 65% sugar, and you can say that you have 35% water. Now, what is important about this limit and how can we use it? We can say that at 20 degrees Celsius, if the sugar concentration in the solution is less than 65%, it means that this is I'm in this phase here where it is one phase that is liquid. So the solution will be like syrup. Now, if I have a solution that have water and sugar at 20 degrees Celsius, but I have, let's say, 80% sugar and 20% water, I'm sure that I'm going to have a two-phase solution which will contain liquid and solid. So if 20 degrees Celsius, the concentration of sugar is more than 65% in my solution, I will end up having a serum and a sugar, which is a two-phase solutions. I hope this clarifies how we're going to use it and giving you a general idea about what is a phase diagram, how it look like, and what is the simplest form of it, which is the one that has one solubility limit, and we use the simple example of sugar and water. Thank you, until next time.